The surveyor has pinned the house on this corner lot, and I'm using the pins to set up a robotic total station for excavation and concrete forming layout. With my CAD file in Leica iCON on the tablet, I'm creating points where the pins should be at the outside corners of the building. The surveyor has pinned four corners, which is all I need to get a nice setup. And with the points created, I can choose setup anywhere and level the instrument. This total station is a Leica iCON ICR80, and I'm using a CC180 tablet. Once the instrument is level, I can walk with the prism and tablet over to the first pin. I roughly place the pole over the pin and have the total station turn and lock onto the prism. I make sure that the pole is centered on the pin, and then level the pole. Then I tap start so that it's actively measuring, and tap store. And that's one pin stored for the setup. Then I do the same process for the second pin. Center, level, and store. With 2 points stored, I can open the residuals tab, and I see that I have 2 millimeters and 2 millimeters. This 4 millimeter difference is also seen in this tab, where the calculated distance between the points is 10.998 meters, and the distance measured is 11.002 meters. Again, for the third pin, I center the pole, level it, and store the point. And here are the residuals after 3. Again, the same process for the fourth pin. And after storing the fourth point, you can see I have a residual of 9 millimeters, which isn't the worst thing in the world, but it's not great. So I try toggling off and on some points, and you can see as I do that, that residual gets a little bit better. But ultimately, I decide to use all the points and give iCON as much data as possible. Now I can confirm the setup, and iCON will essentially place my CAD file over top of the pins. I can check this by clicking on one of the lines over this pin, and I can see that I'm 6 millimeters out one way, and 3 millimeters the other way. And when checking the other side of the house, I can see that I'm out 1 millimeter one way, and 3 millimeters the other way. And now I can set some control points for future setups to replicate this setup. I'm using a nail that has an indent in the top for the prism pole to sit in. I go into as-built, and I give this point a name. I level the pole, and I turn on control point. This changes the point from a circle to a triangle on the screen. Then I store the point. My second point is a mag nail in the sidewalk. It's also a temporary benchmark from the surveyors, so I name it TBM. After storing it, I can enter the elevation by going to the sketching app and editing the point. There, I can type the elevation that's written on the sidewalk. And whenever I use this point in future setups, this elevation will be included, and I'll be able to transfer heights. My third point is another mag nail on the sidewalk. You'll notice it's much farther away. I could place another nail in the sidewalk a little closer, but you'll see later that even when going this far out beyond the original setup, I still get great results. After leveling the pole, I name the point, start measuring again, and store it. Those are the 3 control points that I'll use for all of my future setups for layout on this house. And if you'd like to see how accurate this is, I do another setup here with just the 3 control points, and then check how the building sits over top of the pins. And like I showed before, after 2 points you can see the residuals, which look great. And here you see both the same number for calculated and measured. After the third point is stored, I can look at the residuals, see they're nice, and confirm the setup. To give you an idea of how accurate this is, I can check how the line work sits over the survey pins. And when laying out this line, it shows it's 2 millimeters out one way, and 0 millimeters the other way. Three millimeters one way, and 2 millimeters the other way. Two millimeters and 1 millimeter. And over top of the problem pin, it looks like 6 millimeters and 2 millimeters. I'm really happy with how that's sitting over the pins. I can reliably use the 3 control points to lay out the excavation, footings, and walls. And to tidy up my screen a little bit, I can delete the 4 points because I won't be needing them anymore. And if you made it to the end of the video, thanks for watching.